How's it going, guys? Today, we're gonna take a look at how to install the Th3d magnetic base for their Easy Flex 2. My name's Alex, and you're watching Modified 3D. Magnetic bases from Th3d is a simple way to incorporate a flex plate, whether it be their Th3d Easy Flex 2 or something like a WhamBam flex plate, or any just general spring steel flex plate. It applies very easily with the incorporated 3M adhesive on the back, and all we're gonna need to install it is just some isopropyl alcohol and a towel to wipe down our old bed. So with that being said, let's move the camera on in and get to it. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is pull our bed to the frontmost position of the 3D printer and take some isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol. Preferably 90%, but 70% will work if that's all you have available. Thank you, COVID. And we'll give ourselves a nice clean surface to apply that 3M adhesive to. Just take some paper towel, drip a little bit of alcohol on it, and clean your base. Look at all that gunk we got out. We'll give that a second to dry and evaporate off. And while that's drying, we'll go ahead and take the back plate off of our magnet. Just simply find the edge of the 3M adhesive tape and peel it on off. Now I'm only gonna pull back a little bit and put a nice crease there because I wanna be able to adjust it if I need to once it's on the plate. Make sure that your build plate is dry from any isopropyl alcohol and gently place down the magnetic base on top, which afterwards will peel back the sticker. Make sure the plate's perfectly centered and you can actually pinch that corner and go ahead and pull the rest of your sticker off. I'm gonna start from one end and slowly press the air bubbles out. We don't want any bubbling underneath this. Now you don't wanna use your scraper for this. I know it may be tempting, but the metal of the scraper can damage the plate. So just your finger is all you really need. And you don't need to apply much pressure yet because we're just simply getting it seated. You wanna be able to adjust it if you need to. And for anyone wondering, this is the 235 by 235 millimeter plate for the Ender 3. However, obviously this is a 3dFused Kreatos, our new printer. Once we get that down, just go ahead and run your fingers across it all and make sure it's nice and smooth. As you can see there, we've got no bubbles and it is nicely installed. Go ahead and test it with a flex plate. Go ahead and set it down on top. It's really that simple. Just clean your build plate off and slap the magnet down. Now the magnet's good to about 110 degrees on the bed temperature, so you'll never have to worry about any issues there. All magnets have what is called the Curie effect, which is where they start losing magnetism at a certain strength. I've never had an issue with the Th3D magnetic bases on any of my machines, which is why I chose it to go on the 3dFused Kreatos. This will give us the option to switch between any spring steel style bed plate that we like, and we can even still use glass if we would ever choose to. However, I don't know why you would want to. The magnet strength is really good on it. As you can see here, it's a little bit better on the side that's actually metal as opposed to the Easy Mat 2, but you can still use a flex plate with the Easy Mat on the downside. There is still enough grip. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, put them down in the comments. I'll get to them right away. If you're interested in grabbing a magnetic base, I'll have a link to where you can get one in the comments. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.